सर फिलिप सिडनी 1554 टू 1586 रोट एपोलॉजी फॉर पोएट्री। आफ्टर द डार्क मिडल एजेस केम द लाइट ऑफ रिनेसा विच इल्यूमिंड फर्स्ट इटली एंड अदर नेशंस एंड लेटर ऑन इंग्लैंड। इट ब्रॉट रिवाइवल ऑफ लर्निंग एंड विथ इट न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म। So Philip Sidney was the greatest critic of the Renaissance in England. He broke new grounds in literary criticism with his apology for poetry. The Roman Catholic Church always discouraged poetry, but in the 14th and 15th centuries, it was losing its hold on the minds of the people. Though there were revolts, yet as late as 1585, Sidney could not openly defend poetry on its own grounds directly. Therefore, he had to write his book, Apology for Poetry. Apologetically, as an attempt to defend poetry, in his days, says, Sidney regretfully that from almost the highest estimation of learning, poetry was fallen to the level of the laughing stock of children. But it does not deserve the scorn of the learned, but their respect, because it instructs, it is moral, and it is consistent with religion. Thus, he had to prove that poetry was not immoral and even the church should approve of it. Only that the method of poetry was different. In the same period, Stephen Gosson had indicted poetry on four causes. First, poetry is a waste of time. Second, it is the mother of lies. Third, it is the nurse of falsehood. Fourth, Plato had rightly banished poetry from his ideal commonwealth. Sidney took up the challenge and replied each of these charges using the ancient critical authorities like Aristotle, Horace, Cicero, Virgil, and the modern authors like Minterno. The method of Sidney is that he examines poetry in parts and as a whole. He considers the points in favor and the points against. Then he sets for his main thesis that far from being despised, it deserves the highest praise. Sidney stresses the antiquity of poetry as a justification of its validity. Homer, Virgil, and others wrote great poetry. They told in verse the stories that are not literally true but enchanted with imagination. Thus, poetry is as old as mankind. The most important argument in favor of poetry is that the poet is a maker. He invents new things, drawing on his own wit or imagination. He is thus a creative artist. Then the poet uses the idea of reality. In doing so, he creates a new world and gives us not an insight into reality, but an alternative to reality. Then Sidney interprets poetry as an imitation in a quite different way from that of Plato and Aristotle. For Plato, it was imitation in the sense of mimicry. To Aristotle, it was an imitation of reality in which there was something less than nature, but also something more than nature. For him, poetry was an art of imitation for the natural pleasure imitation affords. But to Sidney, poetry is an art of imitation for a specific purpose, to teach and to delight. Yet it is not so much an art of imitation as of invention of creation. It creates a new world altogether for edification and delight of the reader. Thus, for Plato, imitation took place between poetry and the outside world. For Aristotle, it took place within itself. For Sidney, the process of imitation takes place between poetry and the reader. It is the reader who imitates what the poet creates. Poetry, moreover, is superior to history, philosophy, and other branches of knowledge. History gives the particular truth which cannot be changed, and it is only about the past. Philosophy, more or less, deals with an ideal truth. But this truth is in relation with spiritualism. Civic and law deal with the duties of a citizen, but these may change in every age. But it is only poetry which gives an ideal of truth which relates to the past, to the present, and to the future. Thus, Sidney contributed significantly to the theory of poetry. Please subscribe my channel and don't forget to like and share it. Click on the notification bell so that you can get notified first as my new video is uploaded. Thank you.